As you're working around this area here, a little bit more active in the trot, a little bit more positive in the trot, and my main interest is on acceptance of the outside rein. So in this first phase of the work, I'll very often take the contact more in the outside rein to the point where the horse will look to the outside a little bit. So for example here, is it Daniela there? On the chestnut, yeah? I will get it eventually. So as you're going around Daniela, if you wait for the acceptance of the outside rein, you can keep a little bit bent to the outside while you keep your inside leg on, but relaxed enough in your hip so that you're not pointing your toe out too much. You don't want to use your spur all the time. When the neck, when he accepts it, for example, now you can let him straighten the neck, yeah? Yeah, good. Okay, after this time, come back to a walk. And I just want to now talk about something in relation to the way you communicate with your leg. Come back to a walk now, that's right. And when we communicate with our horses through the senses, we're mainly talking about the language of touch, touching with our leg, touching with the bit to the horse's mouth. We touch in a sense through the use of our seat. The horse feels that. Of course, the other senses come into it, such as the voice or the sounds cause a reaction. And yeah, we can ignore smell and taste for the time being, but eyes, ears, and feeling are all ways in which we mainly communicate with the horse.